What's a nuptial?
Nighttime.
Now.
Getting married.
Your marriage, marriage, okay? Now, what do you notice about this line? So, that character, he's talking to his girlfriend, his wife to be, his fiance.
Fiance.
If you remember, he kidnaps her from the Greek myths we did. He kidnaps her, he brings her back to Athens, and they're gonna get married, and he's saying to her, hey, in 4 days from now, we're gonna get married. 4 happy days, and we're gonna get married. Now, what do you notice about this language? But, oh, methinks how slow this old moon wanes. What's interesting about that use of language? Yes?
Methinks of this old English.
Methinks is right, okay? But anything else about, but, oh, methinks how slow this old moon wanes? How about that?
It's sort of, it's a bit incoherent, sort of.
Maybe. I would say to you that there is a degree of figurative language in that sentence.
Yes.
A moon can't
wane.
A moon can't wane. And the moon's not old. The moon's just the same moon that it's always been.
We're taking away the moon, right?
Yes.
Now,
well, I mean, yes.
What is Theseus saying when he says, but oh, me thinks how slow this old moon wanes? What's he saying? Yeah?
Old people are slow.
He's saying, but oh, these 4 days are going to take so long.
Correct.
I'm so excited, I can't wait.
Correct. He's excited about the wedding. Okay, so we're going to do the first line. From now to, what does a pace mean? A pace. Anybody?
A sentence.
Like if you're on the treadmill, you're pacing yourself. The elliptical.
Elliptical.
It is about a degree of time. It is about a degree. Okay, so we're just going to read that. Okay. Okay. Ready? 1, 2, 3.
Now there in the wild, our nuptial hour draws on the pace.
Okay. So say again.
Now there in the wild, our nuptial hour draws on the pace.
Great. Okay, one more time.
Now there in the light, our nuptial hour draws on a place.
Okay, so think about what, just to pick on Jackson for a minute. The first time we read it, but by the third time, you should think, can I memorize this? Can I memorize this? This is a great way to memorize, to see it, to hear it, to repeat it. You have to really say it out loud. It's a play, it's meant to be performed. But when we learn these sections of the play, you really have to say it out loud so you hear it. Okay, so now the next line. Four happy.
Four happy days bring in another moon.
Okay, again.
Four happy days bring in another moon.
Nice accent. One more time.
Four happy days bring in another moon.
Okay, now from the top.
Now there in the horizon, our nuptial hour draws on the face.
Four
happy days bring in.
So fast. Now, the tendency is to go fast, but when we see the Shakespeare on the 18th, someone's going to get up there and they're going to do it in the old English, and it's amazing because we will have read it and we will have talked about it, and when people present, it is truly amazing because they're up. Has anybody been to the Folger before? Folger
Is that the day when we get a new English?